Hello, welcome to Scrap Time episode 1066. My name is Christina, and on today's episode, I'm showing you the Fawn Scripty Saying stamp set. Today, I am showing you the Fawn Scripty Saying stamp set. And there's a bunch of, let's see, 8 different sayings. Everything from hello you, happy birthday, congratulations, thinking about you, get well soon. So lots of little messages. What's great is the length of the stamps. You can use these on cards, an A2 card, both horizontally and vertically. So I made these simple cards here with some masking and distress inks. This one I went from like the yellow to the blue. And here I did sort of yellow, orange, pinks, and reds. Then I moved from a gradation of reds here. I really like this one with the different grays and smokes and blacks and stuff. And then blues. So I'm going to show you how I made these. Oh, and you can see on the bottom where I stamped the Scripty saying on all of them. It just fits nicely in there. So there you go. So I used a mat that had all the measurements on it. And then I put my card down. And this is how I got my masking. So I used washi tape that's about 3/8 of an inch in width. Just get the end. And I know that I need a quarter. Or not a quarter, an eighth at the top. I'm just going to stand up so I can see what I'm doing a bit more. So then I do the next one and I leave half an inch between. So I know that's an eighth, so that's a quarter and that's a half. So I lay my tape down. Now you don't want to put too much pressure because when we remove the tape, we don't want it to remove the paper, which does happen sometimes. So I need another half inch, which is here. And this is why I use the cutting mat, so I can see my lines. I don't have to get out a ruler and deal with all that. So that's a quarter, so there's a half. Another half, and then just at the bottom, there will be a little bit. So there, we have our card all masked off. So I'm going to be doing a yellow, abandoned coral, picked raspberry, ripe persimmon, and festive berries. So I start with my lightest color, which in this case is the mustard seed. I get some ink on there, and then I just start at this end, putting it on. Now because I'm using 5 colors, I want to sort of do about a fifth of the card. Now I find if you put too much ink on, that's sometimes when the tape tears up at the paper. I think it sort of wets it. I think that's what happens. Now I like to put a bit of the yellow over the next color where I'm going to overlap it. Sort of like that. So then I'm going to use the coral and I'm going to use the same sponge for this. And sort of blend it into that yellow. I don't want the abruptness. I may go back with the yellow too after. So I'm going to do picked raspberry. Mm-hmm. ripe persimmon. Now, of course, you can choose any colors that you want if you were doing Halloween cards like this. You know, with purples and greens would be really cool. If you were doing Christmas, you could do either reds and greens or blues. This would work with any combination for so many different occasions. And I'm going to end with some festive berries. And then, as I said, I'm going to go back with a little mustard seed and just sort of blend that gradation. Okay, so now's the moment of truth of taking off the tape. So you want to do it carefully in case it did catch on any of the paper. And I also find that when I start by pulling it on an angle, I sometimes get a better result than if you're pulling it straight. I find it may be more apt to rip, so I pull it on an angle. So you can see how pretty that looks. So I'm going to move this. I'm going to clean it later because of the ink on it. I'll just clean it with some water later. So I'm going to get a stamp. I'm going to do happy birthday to you because I find personally that's the cards I give the most. I could even leave it you could leave it until you have the occasion and then just stamp the greeting that will work for the occasion. When I use these long stamps, I like to sometimes just place them on my table or my mat and then use my little block here to pick it up. And that's one way to try and get it straighter. If you put it down, sometimes it will curve on you. Ink it up. And then we just sort of line it up in that little white space. I'm going to go a little this way with it. And there we have our happy birthday to you. So that's a really easy way you can make some cool cards with your distress inks and then stamping with the Scripty sayings from Long Fawn. Well, that's it for today's episode. Be sure to check out our website at www.scriptime.ca. And on our next episode, I'm showing you the Insight to Book. So please join us. Thanks for watching Scrap Time.